Om Shanti, today is the 151st day of your godly blessing, and Baba today reminds us about our original, eternal form, when we were with God in the Supreme Abode, or Nirvandham, or Paramdham, or Alam-e-Arwah, as the Muslims say it. That time we were completely pure. God is completely pure. Why? Because He doesn't have a body of His own. If He doesn't have a body, He doesn't have greed for things, He doesn't have desires for things, He doesn't get angry when He doesn't get things. So automatically He's always pure. That means as a soul, His mind and His intellect don't have any negative or impure thoughts or waste thoughts. Whereas we souls, over a period of time, when we come down from golden age or heaven on earth, we come down from a time when there's everything, our thoughts also pure, and we slowly come down. The consciousness of the souls, they fall down to a certain level. That's why we call it Kali Yuga, because the consciousness of souls has fallen down. In Satyuga, that means the golden age, the time when the Satya Pita or the Satya Father or the true Father, true God Father had created that world. That's why we call Him as Satyam Shivam Sundaram, because Satya word is only used in front of God Father Shiva's name. So God Father Shiva is an incorporeal being, not the corporeal Shankar. Both of them are different. So God says, when I am there in Paramdham, because Shankar cannot be there in Paramdham. He cannot go with a body to Paramdham, right? I cannot go with my body to Paramdham. We did not come with anything. We will not take back anything. We came naked, we'll go naked. So God says, who will go naked? I, the soul, will go naked up. God is always naked without a body. So God says, remember that time when you were completely pure in the Paramdham. And remember the time when I'd send you down on earth, you were completely pure that time also. But that time you had a body. That time you had a kingdom. So God says in this blessing, let's see. He says, may you be completely pure and realize your original and eternal real form. Original and eternal, completely eternal real form. That means I am a soul, I am a pure soul, child of God the Father. You are a soul, a pure soul, child of God the Father. So then let's go into details. Both the original and eternal forms. Original form, soul in Paramdham. Eternal form, when you come down on earth also. Forms of souls are pure. Both the time we were pure completely. It's now that in Kali Yuga that we become impure, that our thoughts have started attracting negativity, thinking negativity, seeing negativity in other people. That's the big problem over here. Impurity is artificial. God says it's not your original thing. Originally, when a diamond or gold is pure, you know that if something happens to the gold, you can put fire, you can use fire, and you can remove the impurity. Similarly, over here, God says you are pure. Now remember me. Be in my remembrance, be in that tapasya of fire, and you'll remove your impurities. Then, it is a gift from Shudras, Baba says. Impurity is artificial. It is a gift from Shudras. Shudras are not those who are cobblers who clean the drainages or the septic tanks. They're not Shudras. God says the ones who have impure thinking, who manipulate, who have ego, jealousy, greed, lust, they are Shudras. That's God's definition. And what we have done? The humanity has put people into different caste systems and we have called them as Shudras. That's wrong. Shudra is somebody who could be a millionaire but he has very low thinking. That person can also be a Shudra. So God says, impurity is artificial. It is a gift from Shudras. Brahmins cannot use things that belong to Shudras, right? That's what they should do. They don't even allow the Shudras to enter the house. They don't allow Shudras to enter the temples. God says, a lowly being, a soul who thinks very dirty thoughts, is not allowed to come to God's temple, Paramdham, not the physical temples over here. So God says, like in the world, Brahmins don't touch Shudras. So if you want to become a Brahmin, Brahmin means the child of Adam, the purest of being, who has pure thoughts, without lust, without anger, without greed, without ego, without jealousy. That soul is a Brahmin soul. Whereas a soul who has impure thoughts is a Shudra. So Brahmins cannot touch Shudras, or they don't allow Shudras to touch anything. That means you being a Brahmin, you cannot touch impure thinking. See, we say that somebody's words touched my heart or mind. Similarly, impure thoughts cannot touch your mind and your heart. Otherwise, you become a Shudra, I become a Shudra. So God says, be careful. You can turn from a Brahmin to a Shudra just by thinking. So God says, it's not by what you do, it's by what you think. And so just have the thought in my original and eternal real form, I means this soul, am a pure soul, just like God the Father is pure. So the practices of thinking of self without a body. So when we practice of self without a body and I think I'm a soul, then do I need too much to eat? Do I need too much money? Do I need too much of property and wealth and jewelry? Do I need name, fame? No. But if I think of myself as a body, I need everything for the body. So that's the difference between thinking like hell and thinking like heaven. So God says, I, the soul, am a pure soul. That's the practice which we do in Brahma Kumaris. And that's the meditation practice. So Baba says in details, whenever you look at others, now this is very crucial, whenever you look at others, look at their real forms. What were they? Even if your husband or wife or children, they were originally pure. So change your vision towards them. Because if you always complain and crib about, my husband is like this, my wife is like this, my children are like that, they've got this bad habit, then you're increasing it more. God says, think of them, see from this eye that they are souls. They were originally God's children and they have taken many births because of which they have become impure, they become body conscious. Now it's time to look at their souls, as in their sanskars or habits, their thoughts. And somewhere in their thoughts, their purity, that purity is still there. Look at that purity. So God says, whenever you look at others, look at their real forms, realize your real form, and you will become completely pure. That's the method. If you keep on looking at other people's negativity, their mistakes, our own mind starts thinking negative and our own mind becomes depleted of pure energy and we start doing those mistakes over a period of time. What we blame others of, we also start doing those mistakes. So God says, keep yourself lighter, realize your real form and you will become completely pure and claim a first class air condition ticket. See, to go back to Paramdham, there are four ways. Either you are in third class ticket, that means you have very impure thoughts and the time comes when you leave the body, it becomes very difficult for you to leave the body because only pure souls can return back. Next is second class, a little less impure thoughts, you are able to leave your body with little less pain. First class ticket, even more less impure thoughts, so you are able to leave your body little better. But air conditioned ticket means you have taken care of your thoughts. You don't have impure thoughts, you're able to leave your body nicely, without any trouble, without any regrets, without any guilt. So I leave you with this beautiful vartan. Think about it, contemplate about it. Have a blessed day. Om Shanti.